we actually structured and organized knowing what we wanted. We wanted a real school, in-school experience for these kids. And so even though we had the very tight timelines, our priorities were basically get these kids in class, and then at the same time, make sure that the right supports are in place.
I think what we needed to do was be as prepared as we could, presenting that calmness that you need before something big like this starts. So just letting the staff and parents know that it's a process and that it was going to take a little while to get everything up and running, but we were here for them and making sure that everybody was where they were supposed to be. But I would say confidently within the first 2 or 3 days, everybody was exactly where they were supposed to be in terms of the grade, the programming they were looking for, French immersion, their teaching assignment, all of that.
Few seconds to show you my virtual setup. I have a virtual grade 6 class, and I just want to show you how I got things managed.
A Chromebook here, and I got another keyboard set up to it to make it easier to type. And this is the Chromebook that I use to manage my Google Meet. Here, what I also have is a Google Choice board that I made through Jamboard. Just lets the students choose sometimes what activities they're working on. The student view, so I log into the Google Meet a second time so I can see what the students are seeing themselves.
Like, I'm just amazed at how welcoming and inviting it is every day for these kids to come in. Like, you really do feel, from what they put on the screen and from what they're presenting of themselves, like it's fun, engaging environment that kids want to go to every day.
The transition to get technology into the house and get it set up was seamless. A quick phone call was made, and in less than 48 hours, we had technology in the house, all set up. IT tech had contacted me to make sure everything was working, and we were good to go before the first day of school. So that was really nice to have that support in place and have the school respond so quickly to make sure that Helen had the right technology that she needed so her learning could continue when school started.
That the key to that is making sure that they have the resources they need. So we've spent a lot of money and funds to have virtual resources purchased, codes for those kids and for those teachers to use so that they have what they need in order to run a classroom. And then also just providing them with the Chromebooks, the webcams, the headsets, so they have the technology, and it's day to day. We have an IT department that's helping our teachers out daily, and if it means we have to go out to their sites to help them, we do it. If it means troubleshooting here from our end, just that open communication all the time.
It's a lot easier since I'm at home, and if I'm having technical problems, I can talk to my teacher or my mom.
We've had a positive response for the most part because parents have been a key partner in this process, and I think there was a lot of patience and a lot of support and faith that we would have a very, very good product delivered to them as far as the online learning module. So yeah, we're hearing some good things. I think our teachers are doing a fantastic job. Some of the assignments that we've seen are snapshots of how teachers are even delivering the curriculum. Very creative, very innovative, and I think parents are appreciative of that.
With the virtual learning program, it's been actually excellent. He's learned how to use the computer. He's learned how to make his own slides.
Helen's teacher this year has been exactly mirrored to what I would expect it would be in the classroom. I barely even know that Helen's here doing school, except for recess and lunch. She's totally engaged. There's total teaching online with the teacher live throughout the whole entire day. Homework has been the same. Learning has been the same. I've been quite amazed how well her teacher has actually done to keep the kids interested and engaged and using different learning tools. I was very concerned that doing online learning, she might fall behind and not get the same quality of education as they were going to get in person. But that hasn't been the case, and it's been wonderful.
We just started to get random emails or phone calls saying thank you and that, you know, it was going smoothly. And what I wanted the most and what I did hear was that they were starting to feel like their kids were part of a class and part of a school. And that was important to me because I knew then that our teachers had reached out and somehow made kids feel like they were in school in a virtual platform, which was what we wanted.
Our school now has a formal name, just like every other school in our system. The name of the virtual school is St. Isidore of Seville Catholic Elementary Virtual School. So that process, really, we follow the same type of process that we would do for any new school in our system. There is a policy in place. We ask for community input, stakeholder input, 147 submissions were collected. Students did some great work. A lot of teachers took this on as even an assignment for their students. And we were able to finalize a name, and it was passed by our board. And also we have a mascot, which is the RAM. It stands for Random Access Memory. We're the largest community as far as being a school in our system, but we are still very much a community, a faith-based community of learners. And that continues even on our virtual platform.